You're watching Monty TV. I'm Jackie Karsh, sitting down now with Geoffrey Van Maltzahn, general partner at Flagship Pioneering, which is a venture firm that invents technologies and starts companies. Thanks so much for sitting down with me.
Thanks for having me.
So what are you guys working on?
Almost everything that we're working on is at the confluence of artificial intelligence interacting with science. Most of that is focused on life science. And the reason the river of science and the river of AI flowing together is going to be a big deal is that most of science works in ways that our human brains aren't well suited to understand. And machines don't have a lot of our limitations. And so it's allowing us to blaze new trails and create new technologies that are really cool.
Why did you create this business model where you're supporting the companies that you're actually building?
So the insight that Nubar had at the beginning of Flagship was that if you could bring under one roof 100 or so founding experiences in companies and not lose the forever young perspective that you should be inventing the things that come next and learning the rules by which those will become extraordinary, then you might eliminate a lot of the unforced errors and, you know, the kind of diarrheal diseases that kill startups. And you might be able to create the most extraordinary ones. And one of the beautiful things about the sort of jump that biology is experiencing right now is that almost by definition, many of the most impactful life science companies have not been started yet. Like, they're either itty bitty startups or they're, you know, a twinkle in someone's eye right now. But some of those are going to become the most important companies in the world. So it's a beautiful time to be in life sciences.
You're obviously someone who has experience in the sciences. Do you need to have that kind of experience in order to start a company in that space?
Great question. The archetype for many CEOs in biotech is sort of oriented towards maximal experience. A cartoonish archetype of tech is like high school dropout. Biotech is going to start to look like a hybrid between those twos, because as the tools get more and more sophisticated and distinct from what's been used in the past, youth will be an advantage, like people who can just put a million hours into figuring out that new competitive edge. At the same time, in healthcare and in agriculture and other areas of life sciences, you can't break things. Like, you operate in either delicate economic conditions in commodity markets or you know, where you're actually making life and death decisions. And therefore experience matters too. So creates this wonderful hybrid of you know, people who are actually young or forever young, kind of intermingling and trying to figure out the best combination of prior experience with first principle thinking to figure out what's next.
What are you most excited about when you see the technology infusing with biosciences?
Yeah. So. It's hard when you've been in biology for a long time. You can lose appreciation for how significant it is that proteins come from DNA, for example. So what that means is that every single therapeutic property for hundreds of billions of dollars of medicines is implicitly written into the sequence of DNA that they come from. And humanity has had no ability to read that language. We've been seeing the letters of DNA for the past 20 plus years, but we haven't really understood what they mean. So as we gain the ability to, you know, start to read the Shakespeare of life, the capacity to be able to understand how disease really works and intervene against it is going to radically improve. So some of the stuff that we're doing right now, I couldn't have imagined us doing 3 years ago, let alone 10 or more.